Hello students, welcome to SBR online classes. Yesterday we were seeing about the types of chemical reactions, and as you people know, there are 5 types of chemical reactions: combination, decomposition, displacement, double displacement, and redox reactions. So I have already taught you all combination reactions, where combination reaction states that when two or more substances react, the resultant will be a single product. Such reactions are called as a combination reaction. Then later on we went with the decomposition reaction. Decomposition, we will see the decomposition. Yesterday a part of it was being taught out, and today we will see the other part of the decomposition reactions. Decomposition reactions. See, you people know that decomposition reactions are opposite of combination reactions, and base decompose, they are opposite of combination. Other thing you people should know that opposite of combination reaction. Then these reactions are endothermic. They are endothermic. Endothermic means they absorb heat energy. I repeat, decomposition reactions are endothermic, where they absorb heat energy. They require heat energy to break down the substances. Decomposition reactions are those where a single reactant decomposes to form two or more products. For example, AB is a substance. It undergoes decomposition reactions to form A plus B. If they want to decompose, the word decompose, I can write decompose here, means split. In order to split down or in order to break down, they require energy. So they absorb energy. The energy is either absorbed in the form of a heat, or they either use energy in the form of electric current, or the absorption is in the form of a light. Based upon the way they absorb the heat to break down the things, we have got 3 types of decomposition reaction. First one was thermal decomposition reaction, what we read it yesterday. So thermal decompositions are reactions are those which make use of heat to break down. And the examples what we have seen here was when in ferrous sulfate crystals, FeSO4, 0.7 H2O, these crystals are green in color. I have explained to you that they undergo decomposition reactions when it is being heated out. Take a test tube, dry test tube, add ferrous sulfate crystals and heat it with the help of the burner. When you heat it with the help of the burner, what happens? This ferrous sulfate crystals decomposes to form ferrous sulfate, FeSO4, and along with that water molecules are lost. As there is a loss of water molecule, the green color changes and it becomes colorless. See, it becomes colorless. And on further decomposition, see, this ferrous sulfate, if you go on heating on further, it further undergoes decomposition reaction. FeSO4 undergoes decomposition to form a characteristic smell of sulfur dioxide, SO2, and SO3. Along with that, a brown residue is being formed, Fe2O3. Brown color residue. So this reaction shows that heat energy is utilized to break down the substances. The resultant might be two or more product. So such reactions are called as a thermal decomposition reaction. Another one we saw yesterday was when lead nitrate, PbNO3, taken twice, when it is being heated out, you can see PbNO3 decomposes to form lead oxide, PbO. Along with that, nitrogen dioxide is being formed, and you can also see oxygen is being formed. Two or more, we have got 3 products over here. So the color of this is yellow. Yellow residues of lead oxide is being formed. Such type of reactions are called thermal decomposition reactions. So today we will see the other type of decomposition reaction, that is electrolytic decomposition reactions. What are electrolytic decomposition reactions? See, electrolytic decomposition reactions are those reactions where we make use of electric current. See, in thermal we used heat. Now we'll take an example where we use electric current to break down the substances. If you are using an electric current, such decomposition reactions are called as an electrolytic decomposition. Electrolytic decomposition. The word electro. Electro means we are using electric current. Electric. And electric current is being used out. Lyasis. Lyasis means breaking or splitting. Any terms can be used out. So if you are making use of electric current to break out the compounds, such type of reactions are called as an electrolytic decomposition reaction. So the best example for this we will see electrolysis of water. Electrolysis of water. See, here also you can understand that always lyasis stands for breaking. So you are using lyasis breaking, you are using electric current to break down the water molecules. So in order to break down the water molecules, we have got a simple experiment. Let me explain you. Take a beaker. I have taken a beaker. Then I will drill a hole at the base. At this base, I just drill a hole. So the purpose of drilling the hole is that I want to fit the rubber tubes here. Rubber tubes, so that I can place an electrodes in it. I can insert an electrode. Take a beaker at the base, make two holes. You have to drill a hole so that I can fit a rubber stoppers. These are rubber stoppers. Stoppers. Then I will insert an electrodes. They are carbon electrodes. Electrodes. And to these electrodes, I will connect it to a 6 volt battery. This is switch. And switch is connected to a battery of 6 volt. So, and an electrode is being connected to a 6 volt battery where you have to pass a current. Then fill this electrodes with water. Fill this beaker with the water so that electrodes are completely dipped in it. Okay. Then take two test tubes. And insert the take the two test tubes which is filled with water and insert it in these electrodes. On these electrodes, I am inserting the test tubes. So these test tubes are filled with water. See, these test tubes are filled with water and they are being reversed and inverted and placed where electrodes are being inserted in it. Okay, so I explain you once again. These are test tubes. Beaker. I have taken water. Water is nothing but it is acidified water. Acidified water means I have added few drops of sulfuric acid over here. Okay, so experiment is being set up. I have to take a beaker, drill the hole at the base. So so that you can place the rubber stoppers. To the rubber stoppers, I have immersed a carbon electrodes. Okay, then fill the beaker with the water and insert the two test tubes which are filled with water. The test tubes which are being filled out with water should be inserted where two electrodes are being placed out. These electrodes are being connected to a 6 volt battery. And set up the experiments and leave it for some time. You can see some changes over here. When a current is being passed through the water, what happens? Electrolysis of water takes place. You can see the water breaks up. The water molecules breaks up to form hydrogen and oxygen. This is what we know. But how to identify the particular gases and hydrogen and oxygen, we'll come to know. See, the two electrodes, one is connected to a positive, another is connected to a negative. Positive is anode. And negative is cathode. And you can see the formation of bubbles coming out. The number of, see, when the current is being passed out, you can see in one of the test tubes, the bubble formation is more compared to the other test tube. The bubble formation is less. See, by this you can come to know that the water is being displaced. These bubbles formation indicates that the gas is being collected in the test tubes. As the gas starts collecting out in the test tube, what happens? The water gets displaced. and starts gas starts accumulating. Once the gas is completely filled out, remove the test tube and we'll test it out the gas. We don't know which type of a gas it is actually. So when you remove out, we go for the test tube. Let us take the gas filled out in the cathode. Cathode, what gas is? Cathode is negatively charged. Okay, see, when you bring a burning sphincter towards the test tube where the gas cathode is being collected, the test tube is being collected out, you can see the gas burns out with the pop sound. You can see the popping of the sound. The pop sound is being produced out and the gas starts burning. It burns out. See, the pop sound is a confirmatory test for a hydrogen gas. I have told you earlier also, if the gas produces pop sound while burning, then the respective gas is a hydrogen gas. That means towards the cathode, you can see the gas collected is a hydrogen gas and it is double that of the other one. Double that of the, and hydrogen is plus and this is cathode. You can see opposite charges, you know. So, always hydrogen gets collected at the cathode. Then another test tube, take another test tube and bring a burning sphincter very close to it, and you could see that the burning sphincter burns very brightly. Why does it burns brightly? Because oxygen is a supporter of combustion. So as it burns very brightly, then you come to know on the cathode the gas collected is oxygen, because it burns brightly. Burns brightly. So, as it burns brightly, then the gas collected is oxygen. And I have told you, as the number of bubbles are more, it indicates that the gas collected is more than that of the other test tube. And as you know that, it is double, that means hydrogen is two part and oxygen is one part. That means water is in the ratio of 2:1 by volume. See, always it is being asked, what is the ratio of water, what is water made up of? Water is made up of 2 atoms of hydrogen and 1 atom of oxygen. It is 2:1 by volume in this way. See, another, please you have to make a note that what is the equation it is. Actually, electrolysis of water, you have to write water H2O. On the arrow, what are the reaction conditions? The reaction conditions are, you are using electric current. So, when you are using an electric current, this water molecule splits up to form hydrogen and oxygen. So, this is an equation for an electrolysis of water. Water is in the ratio of 2:1 by volume. And if you, as both are colorless gases, so in order to know which gas is being collected in which test tube, so you have to go for the confirmatory test. When you bring a burning splinter to the test tube where the gas is being collected more, if it burns with a pop sound, indicates that the gas is a hydrogen. If the gas burns brightly without producing the pop sound, that is understood that it is an oxygen gas. See, I have told you earlier also, decomposition reaction is opposite of combination reaction. Just let me tell you. See, in combination reactions, I have told you, you have got a single reactor. You have got two or more reactant and the product are single. So, same thing. I'll write down. Example for combination, what you have taken? When an hydrogen atom combines with an oxygen, it produces water. So, the reactants are, the reactants, you have got two or more reactants, but product is single. Such type of reactions are called as a combination reaction. See, when I am talking about decomposition reaction means the reactant should be single. Reactant should be single means I have taken water molecule and I decomposes in the form of, in the presence of electric current. When I decomposes in the presence of electric current, this water molecules get decomposes to form H2 plus O2. And this is an example for decomposition reaction. See, many a times it so happens that whenever they will ask you write in chemical equations for the electrolysis of water, people get confused because you people are quite perfect with the equations. Water decomposes to form hydrogen and oxygen. So, the correct way of representation is must. By looking at this, you can come to know the difference that in combination, reactants are double, product is single. And in decomposition, the reactant is single, product is Double. See, for decomposition reaction, if you are giving the equation in this form, it is wrong. Because this is an example for a combination. You explain the whole thing, and when equation has to be represented, if you represent the equation in a reverse manner, that is wrong way of representation. You should be very particular while writing a chemical equations over here. So such type of decomposition reactions are called as an electrolytic decomposition. So example for electrolytic decomposition is, you are making use of electric current. Electro means electric and lysis means breaking. Here you are using electric current to break the water molecules. Another example, a simple example we can give you is that sodium chloride. Molten sodium chloride. When a current is being passed through molten sodium chloride. Molten sodium chloride means NaCl. If I pass an electric current through the molten sodium chloride, what happens? Molten means this is in the form of aqueous. So I am passing an electric current over here. See, when electric current is passed through molten sodium chloride, this sodium chloride gets split into two, that is sodium and chlorine. You get a sodium metal, Na metal, and gas is being given out. Sodium gas is being given out, Cl2, 2Na, Cl2Na. So this is usually used to, see, sodium metal is usually extracted from the sodium chloride, that is a common salt. When a metal, sodium metal is, you know, we have got large amount of common salt available. So metal is used, sodium metal is usually extracted from the electrolysis of sodium chloride. What we do, take a molten sodium chloride, pass the electric current, what happens, this sodium chloride splits up to form sodium metal and a chlorine gas is being released. This is one of the other example for electrolytic decomposition of chemical in chemical reactions. I hope this is quite clear. Then we will go with the next type of decomposition reaction, that is photochemical decomposition reaction. See, photo, the word photo stands for light. Photo, so when the substances absorbs heat energy, you can see there is change in the chemicals. Such type of reactions are called as a photochemical decomposition reactions. Photochemical reaction. See, the word photo stands for light. Understood? Photo means light. So here, photo means light. That means here the substances absorbs light energy to decompose the substances over here. So such reactions are called as a photochemical decomposition reactions. Here an example is photochemical decomposition of silver chloride. Photochemical decomposition of silver chloride. See, silver chloride is AgCl. The molecular formula for silver chloride is AgCl. Okay. Then what I have to do? I will be taking 2 grams of silver chloride in a china dish. So the china dish is being taken out. In this I place silver chloride, AgCl. Silver chloride is being kept out. 2 grams of silver chloride is being kept in a china dish, out exposed to the sunlight. So this is the light source where we are using. See, it is not that always sunlight is being natural light is to be used out. This can also work out with the artificial lights, also can be used out for photochemical decomposition. So silver chloride is being exposed to the sunlight for sometimes. After sometimes, the color of the silver chloride is white powder. It is a white powder. After sometimes, you can see the color of this changes. It changes, the white powder changes to grayish white. Grayish grayish white color. Grayish white color indicates that Ag, the position of Ag. I'll just show you the reactions. AgCl in presence of sunlight, it get decomposes to form Ag plus Cl2. So chlorine is in the form of a gas. It escapes out in the atmosphere and so this is a grayish white in color, grayish white powder. You will, you can see the change, and this is white color powder. And such type of reactions are called as a photochemical reactions. Photochemical reactions are those reactions where they make use of light to decompose the substances. When a substance, for example, if I have taken a silver chloride, when silver chloride is exposed to a sunlight, leave it for some time, you can see a white color of the silver powder changes to form grayish. The color of the silver is gray in color. You can see the silver is being left out in a china dish where the chlorine escapes out. So this is photochemical reactions, and this is usually used in a very important for 1 marks. Where do we use this? This is used in black and white photographies. This is being used out. See another example, you can have silver bromide. When silver bromide again in the presence of sunlight, so it is pale yellow in color. The color of this is pale yellow, silver bromide, pale yellow. When it is being exposed to sunlight, you can see the same reaction, Ag plus Br2 is being formed. Br2 again get vaporized, and the color of this again is grayish white in color, grayish white in color. So such type of reactions are called as a photochemical decomposition reactions. Is it clear? So this is all about the decomposition reactions. Decomposition reactions are those where we make use of either heat or you make use of electric current, or you are making use of a sunlight. Based upon that, we have got different types of decomposition reactions over here. So next we are going to see about displacement reactions. What are displacement reactions? So this is quite interesting, displacement reaction. Displacement reaction. What is displacement reaction? Highly reactive element displaces the less reactive element here. So displacement reactions are those where a highly reactive element displaces the less reactive elements over here. Such reactions are called as a displacement reaction. Highly reactive metal displace less reactive metal. So such type of reaction is displacement. Let me give an example, and you should know that displacement reactions usually occur in the solution state. They should be in the solution state, and they are exothermic. Exothermic means the heat energy is given out to the surroundings. They are occurring in the solution. Here one is element and other is compound. A is an element. A reacts with BC. BC is a, actually this is a metal. This is in an aqueous state, solution state, right? Because this reaction is usually carry out in an aqueous solution, is it? So here what happens, A will displace B to form AC, and B is given out. That means displacement means highly reactive metal will displace the less reactive metal. So such type of reaction is called as a displacement reaction. Let me give you an example. Iron reacts with copper sulfate. So this is an aqueous state. So what happens? Iron will displace copper to form iron sulfate. FeSO4 plus copper is given out. Such type of reactions are called as a displacement reaction. To make this clear, let us take an activity over here. So, how this activity is being conducted out? I will take three iron nails. Iron nails are being taken now. So, just have a look. A stand is being placed now. So, to this, so I'll take a test tube with an stand and just put the test tube to hold it down. In this, what I'll do, I'll put a copper sulfate solution. I've put around 10 ml of copper sulfate solution, FeSO4 solution, 10 ml of copper sulfate solution, so that the iron nail what I have placed will be dipped in it. So I'll place an iron nail over here. I'll take 3 iron nails. Among the 3, 2 I have taken for the experimental purpose, and this is being tied out with the thread and it is being left out. So what did I do? Iron nail is being taken out. This is an iron nail which is being tied to a thread over here. And this iron nail is dipped in a copper sulfate solution. So before I take an iron nail for the experimental purpose, I have to the iron nail should be cleaned with the sandpaper. Earlier also it is being told out, clean with the sandpaper. So why we have to clean it with the sandpaper means to remove out the coating, because metals always react with the atmosphere. So in order to remove the coating and to get the desired product, it has to be cleaned out before the using for the experiment. So iron nail, before I take it for the experimental purpose, so it is being cleaned out with the sandpaper, which is an abrasive material. So after that, 2 is being used for the purpose of an experiment, 1 is for the comparison what we are going to do. Then what we will do, you can see 2 test tubes are being taken out along with that. 2 test tubes. I have taken 2 test tubes. I don't think it is visible. Two test tubes I'll take here so that it will be visible for you. So in these 2 test tubes I will add copper sulfate solutions. See, the copper sulfate solution here is being added. This is test tube A and this is test tube B. So the color of the copper sulfate solution is blue in color. Actually it is blue in color. So this is filled with copper sulfate solution and it is blue in color. Okay, so both the test tube copper sulfate solution is being placed out, but what happens here? Let us see about the things. When an iron nail is dipped in a copper sulfate solution and left it for around 20 minutes, then after leaving out for the 20 minutes, remove the iron nail from the test tube. So this is an original how the before I insert the copper iron nail inside, the color of the solution what I had copper sulfate solution was blue in color. Okay, see what happens when iron nail is being left out for 20 minutes. After removing the things, you could see that the color of the copper sulfate solution changes to be green in color. I have told you earlier also, chemical reactions, during the chemical reactions you can see when a reaction has been taken place, either you will have a change in color, change in temperature, and here when you see there is a change in color in the solution, indicates that a chemical reaction has taken place. So what happens here, when iron nail is being removed out, you can just compare the iron nail, earlier the iron nail and later on the iron nail. See, earlier the iron nail was very neat, what I have kept it for the comparison I have told you. When you take these 2 nails, you can see the color of this iron nail has turned to be brown in color, reddish brown in color, reddish brown in color, brown in color. This indicates that iron has displaced copper from the copper sulfate solution. Why there is a change in color from blue to green? It is only because that iron is a highly reactive metal. It displaces copper from the copper sulfate solution. So the color of the solution changes from blue to green in color. This color becomes green in color. Green in color. And when iron is being kept out, it is due to the presence of Cu plus 2 ions over here. Due to the presence of Cu plus 2 ions, the color of the solution turns to be green in color in the test tube B. But what happens here, the iron which is being removed from the test tube B, you can see it turns to be reddish brown in color. This is due to the deposition or presence of sulfate ions on it. Due to the presence of sulfate ions on it, the iron nail changes to be reddish brown in color. So this indicates that displacement reaction takes place when a highly reactive metal displaces the less reactive metal. So how to come to know which are highly reactive? We have got a reactivity series where you have to know the things which metals comes. Always metals at the top are highly reactive, metals at the bottom are least reactive. Let me give you the reactivity series table for you all. Just see, there is a memorization how to be remembered. See, please stop calling me. How I remember? Please means potassium. Stop, sodium. Please stop calling me a zebra. I stands for iron. So I like means lead. Lead means Pb. I like her is hydrogen. I like her calling copper, mercury, silver, gold and platinum. Mercury, Hg, silver, Ag, gold and platinum. Easy to remember. How to say? How to remember? Please stop calling me a zebra. I like her calling name of the elements mercury, silver, gold and platinum. You have got various way of remembering, but this is how simple way we remember it out. See, to know the things, if you look at the reactivity series, metals at the top, at the top, as you go, these metals are highly reactive. As you come down, they are least reactive. Then when I say iron displaces copper, metal at the top will displace. If you see iron is here, copper is here. So this shows that metals at the top are highly reactive. That means iron is more reactive than the copper. Because iron is more reactive than the copper, copper was easily displaced here. If I write Cu plus FeSO4, do you have the reaction? No reaction here. You don't have any reaction here. Right? No reaction takes place because copper is below the iron. So iron is more reactive, and iron is more reactive, it will not get displaced from the iron sulfate solution. So you can see no reaction taking place. That means displacement reaction takes place when the elements at the highly reactive elements displaces the less reactive metals over here. If the reaction is between calcium and magnesium, calcium is capable of displacing magnesium because calcium is highly reactive than magnesium. So such type of reactions are called as a displacement reactions. Displacement reactions are those reactions where a highly reactive metal displaces the less reactive metals, and these displacement reactions usually occur in the solution state where one is an element, another is a compound over here. And when you are taking A plus B, you can see A is capable of displacing B because B is less reactive than the A. when it is less reactant only, then only the displacement reactions are possible. See, displacement of ferrous sulfate with copper is very important and frequently asked in the examinations. See, what happens here, what we have to do, how was the experiment being done? Once again, I'll revise you all. Three iron nails were being taken out. One was kept for a sample. When you are using an iron nail for the sample, you have to clean out with the sandpapers in order to remove the upper layer or the oxide layer of it. So then take two iron nails, insert it in a copper sulfate solution. See, two test tubes I have taken, A and B. In both the test tubes I have put the copper sulfate solution around 10 ml so that my iron nail gets dipped out. So one is being kept as a sample for the comparison for the color change. Then what we did in test tube B, I have inserted the iron nail with the help of the thread. When it is being inserted out, this is left for around 20 minutes. After 20 minutes, what we did, this iron nail was being removed out. When this iron nail was being removed out, you could see the change in the color of the solution. Earlier, you can see the change in the color. Earlier it was blue, later on it has turned to be green in color. When there is a change in the color, indicates that chemical change has occurred. So this change in the color is due to the presence of Cu plus ions in the solutions. And the iron nail which was being removed out from the solution, you can see it has turned to be brown in color. It is being brown in color when you compare with the nail which was being kept for the sample. See, it turns to be brown in color, indicates the presence of sulfate ions on those, and which has turned the iron nail into brown in color. So this shows that iron displaced copper from the iron has displaced copper from the copper sulfate solution, and you can see the change in the color. Such reactions are displacement reactions. Let me give you another example for you all. And to remember which are the highly reactive metals and how it has to be remembered, please stop calling me a zebra. I like her calling mercury, silver, gold and platinum. See, hydrogen is a non-metal, then too it is being placed out in the reactivity series because of plus. And elements above hydrogen are capable of displacing hydrogen. Elements below hydrogen cannot displace hydrogen gas during the reactions over here. Okay, let me give you another example for the displacement reaction. The second example for displacement reaction is silver nitrate solutions. Displacement reaction for silver nitrate. Silver nitrate. So what I'll do? I'll take a beaker. Again, a beaker is being taken now. So in this beaker, I'll fill the beaker with the silver nitrate solution. Silver nitrate solution. And the color of the silver nitrate is colorless. This is very important, you people should know. Why I mean, writing it is colorless means after the reactions you might be seeing the change in the color also. So this beaker is being taken out. This beaker, I have added silver nitrate solution. You can take approximately 10 ml or 20 ml for the reactions. Then what I do, I dip a copper wire in the silver nitrate solution. See, I am taking the same thing to show the differences. See, to this silver nitrate solution AgNO3, what I have did, I have placed a copper wire in it. A copper wire is being placed over here. This is copper wire. A copper wire is being placed in it. So, when I placed a copper wire in it, what happens? You could see the change in the color. The change in the color is that this color, the color of this changes to be blue in color. Can you imagine white is being blue in color? So what happens? Just you have to know the reactivity series. I forgot. Please. Okay. Potassium, sodium. Stop calling me a See, I again written the reactivity series to make the things very clear. What has happened? When I have taken a silver nitrate solution, the color of the solution was colorless. When I have placed an iron nail, what happens? The color of the solution turns to be blue in color. Yes, it turns to be blue in color. Why it turns to be blue in color? See, highly reactive metal displaces the less reactive metal. If you have a look here, silver comes here. This is silver and this is copper. See, element copper is highly reactive. It is at the top. Elements at the topmost series are highly reactive. As you go down, the reactivity decreases. So, copper is at the top and silver is at the bottom. So, what happens? Silver nitrate, HgNO3, taken twice, it gets displaced when it gets displaced to form copper nitrate. When it reacts with copper, this is a copper wire what we have got. So what happens? This copper is being displaced. So it forms CuNO3 taken twice and Ag is obtained. And you can see a silver coating on this copper wire. Ag coating, silver color coating. So, this indicates the change in the color is due to the formation of copper nitrate over here. So, the color changes to be blue in color. I have told you, you should remember the reactivity series. If you remember the reactivity series, then displacement reaction is very easy. How to remember? Please stop calling me a zebra. I like her calling mercury, silver, gold and platinum. If you remember this series, then you come to know which elements comes at the top and which elements comes at the bottom. And this color change, this is one of the example for the displacement reaction. So today we have seen electrolytic decompositions. We have also seen photochemical decomposition and we have gone through the displacement reaction. So other reactions we will be studying in the next class. Thank you.